Good evening. Premier Rene Levesque has named Tuesday, May 20th, as the date for the Quebec referendum. It's an event he's calling a turning point in the history of the province, and it might also prove to be a turning point in the history of Canada. On that day, after a campaign that lasts only 5 weeks, Quebecers will be voting on whether to give their government a mandate to negotiate sovereignty association. The announcement of the date came today in the National Assembly in Quebec City.
C'est donc mardi. Le 20 mai prochain.
In announcing the referendum date, Premier Levesque stuck to the soft sell approach as reflected in the referendum question. He reminded Quebecers the question clearly states there will be no political change without their permission in a second referendum. As for now, he said his government wanted a mandate to negotiate a new deal, equal to equal. Only a yes vote, he insisted, will wake up English Canada. The word sovereignty was used once in his 11-minute statement. Later at a news conference, Levesque once again answered that inevitable question. What will he do if English Canada refuses to negotiate?
In a democracy, it's very, I think, par for the course that people in public office who are fighting for the status quo, for the maintenance of things as they are, should be negative to the very last moment. That's normal. But it's also normal in a democracy that you accept the voice of the people when it is clearly democratic and it is clearly a majority.
To Claude Ryan in the no camp, Rene Levesque and the yes side are hiding their separatist colors in an attempt to get people to vote yes.
We take the Parti Quebecois and the government at their true word, at the words which they have repeated over the years. Their true objective, their true goal is the political separation of Quebec, and that's what our fellow Quebecers will have to pronounce about on referendum day. Nothing is clearer in my mind.
Trying to counter the yes side's soft sell approach with a hard sell anti-separatist campaign is a potentially risky business for the Federalist side, because if the yes side wins, the Federalists may find themselves boxed into a corner of their own making. Should the yes side win, the Federalists may find themselves the day after the referendum with quite a problem trying to downplay the significance of that yes vote after insisting on its significance all through the campaign. Jason Moskowitz, CBC News, Quebec City.
Rene Levesque will open his campaign for the yes side in the referendum with an appearance tomorrow in the Beauce region south of Quebec City. Claude Ryan will be campaigning in Montreal. For the next 35 days, both leaders will be crossing the province in chartered planes, and members of their special umbrella committees will be out working as well. David Bazet looks at how the two sides plan to run their campaigns.
This will be a door-to-door campaign. Political leaders will crisscross Quebec, and the people here will be bombarded with TV ads. But both sides are relying heavily on personal contact to get out the vote. The Parti Quebecois got into power this way. Now its workers go from door-to-door, ensuring Quebecers that a yes vote is just a vote for negotiations. The strategy appears to be working well for Premier Levesque, who has put together an impressive political bandwagon, including many people from outside the Parti Quebecois who want constitutional change.
And I'm quite willing, and I hope a lot of Quebecers are willing, to give to Mr. Levesque this mandate to go and negotiate on our behalf. Furthermore, I think it's very dangerous to vote no at this particular time, because it would probably put to sleep several million Canadians for another 25 years, and we can't afford that.
The Federalist forces have had troubles getting their act together. The Liberals themselves admit that they were mauled by the PQ in the televised debate on the question. And the Liberal organization has proved to be uneven. They put together the most successful rally of the campaign, filling the Montreal Forum with 12,000 women. Then they came up with a political flop, filling only half the seats in the Chicoutimi Arena. And Liberal leader Claude Ryan has been caught up in contradiction. At one point, he publicly dismissed the referendum question as soft and meaningless. In private, with members of his caucus, he even toyed with the idea of voting yes. Now he's trying to convince Quebecers that a yes vote is a vote for separatism. For Premier Levesque, the challenge of the next 5 weeks will be to maintain the momentum of a well-organized campaign, a campaign that so far at least seems successful in selling the idea that the referendum will initiate negotiations and not necessarily separation. For Claude Ryan and the Federalists, the challenge appears even greater. They've got to start scoring some points, but they've yet to demonstrate that they've come up with an effective game plan. But then, it isn't easy to argue that saying no to negotiations is a way of saying yes to constitutional change. David Bazet, CBC News, Montreal.
Just hours after the referendum call today, Pierre Trudeau was on his feet in the House of Commons defending federalism and warning about the consequences of a yes vote. The occasion was the opening of the throne speech debate and the Prime Minister's first major speech of Canada's 32nd Parliament. Mark Phillips reports.
All three federal party leaders had intended to deal with the referendum in their Leaders' Day speeches, whether or not the voting date was announced. The fact the announcement did come made the speeches all the more relevant. Pierre Trudeau's had been billed as his first major contribution to the referendum debate. He said he was speaking as Prime Minister of Canada. Later, he'll go into Quebec to participate as a Quebecer. In his prime ministerial role, he laid out his familiar vision of Canada as a country where the national interest must prevail, where regional pride and interest derive out of a feeling of loyalty to the country as a whole. And speaking to Quebecers directly in French, he spelled out Ottawa's reaction to the various possible outcomes of the vote, particularly what would happen if Levesque comes to Ottawa with a victory for the yes side.
I will have to begin by telling him that Canada is a sovereign and independent country, and that common markets are set up between sovereign and independent countries. I don't know if one day we will have that type of association with anyone, but since Quebec, for the time being, is not an independent and sovereign country, then there is no question of discussing association with that type of Quebec. And Mr. Levesque might answer, well, since there is no question of discussing association, then let us discuss sovereignty. And of course, the answer will be, Mr. Levesque, you have no mandate to discuss sovereignty. Pure and simple, because you did not put that question, pure and simple, in your referendum.
Trudeau's argument continues to be that the PQ's referendum question is simply too ambiguous to result in a clear mandate to negotiate anything. And also that, while the PQ might say a yes vote gives it the basis to discuss sovereignty, Trudeau says the massive vote given the federal Liberals in Quebec last February gives Ottawa the right to continue to exercise the sovereignty the PQ wants so badly for itself. Joe Clark's remarks were similarly critical of the PQ option. Speaking in French as well, he said Quebec was failing to recognize there was just as much desire for change in the rest of Canada, but that Quebecers had to realize there was no desire to form an association with a sovereign Quebec.
I believe it is essential that we take the opportunity to repeat that the concept of association is also unacceptable to the publics of Canada outside the province of Quebec.
Ed Broadbent joined the Common Front chorus denouncing the PQ option as well, but also blame the Liberals for creating much of the sentiment for separation that now exists in Quebec.
These problems were created by politicians, and in this case, by the Liberals, and not by the Federalists.
Clearly the most important speech of the day, though, was Trudeau's. And while his rejection of the PQ option was strong and categorical, his most direct and emotional appeal to Quebecers is being saved for when he appears in Quebec later in the campaign. Mark Phillips, CBC News, Ottawa.